Hello and welcome to the episode 101 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, among other things, we'll have all kinds of gigs, the first Indian-flavored song of the Beatles, and the first time another musician was credited on a Beatles single. On the 11th of April 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed at a top 10 club in Hamburg for the continuation of their second residency in West Germany. In 1962, Pete Best, John Lennon and Paul McCartney left Liverpool for Hamburg on a plane. The Beatles were about to begin their third Hamburg residency, and their manager Brian Epstein had arranged the plane trip to give the band the impression that the old van and train days were over. George Harrison was sick and left Liverpool the next day with Epstein himself. The lads were high-spirited, but their enthusiasm was short-lived. Once landed in Hamburg, they met their old friend Astrid Kircher, who informed them that her fiancé and former Beatles bass player Stuart Sutcliffe had died on the 10th of April of brain hemorrhage. Needless to say, the band was devastated. Several things happened on the 11th of April 1963. For a start, John Lennon met his son Julian for the first time, 3 days after his birth. One of the things John did before leaving the hospital was putting his wife Cynthia and their son in a private room. Cynthia remembers in her book John, "He knew that both he and I might attract unwelcome attention if I stayed in the public ward. It was wonderful to see him, but privacy was impossible. My room had a window onto the corridor outside, and when word got out that he was there, dozens of patients and staff gathered with their noses pressed to the window. The room felt like a goldfish bowl, and it was obvious John couldn't stay long. He hugged me and signed dozens of autographs on his way out. I was disappointed that we'd had so little time together. He had to go straight back to the tour and wouldn't be home again for a week or so. John's visit was brief, but it had a dramatic effect. The nurses were distinctly friendlier to me than they had been when I first arrived." Also today, From Me to You was released in UK with Thank You Girl on its flip side. It was the Beatles' third single and a big hit from the very start. Finally, at night, the Beatles performed at the Co-operative Hall in Middleton. The performance lasted an hour, much to the rejoice of 300 screaming fans. Soon after jumping off stage, the band returned to Liverpool. In 1964, the Beatles were featured on number 1 and 2 of the album sales chart in Billboard magazine in the United States. Moving on 1 year, in 1965, the Beatles were at the Empire Pool in Wembley. They appeared at the NME 1964-1965 annual Paul Winners All-Star Concert for the third consecutive year. They performed I Feel Fine, She's a Woman, Babies in Black, Ticket to Ride and Long Tall Sally in front of a 10,000-strong audience. Highlights of the evening were edited together and broadcast by ABC Television in their 85-minute special Paul Winners Concert, aired on the 18th of April, Easter Sunday, between 3:15 and 4:40 p.m. in most of England and between 4:10 and 5:35 p.m. in the London area. Immediately after the performance, the Beatles reached the Teddington Studio Centre, also in Wembley, where, after dinner, they took part in the rehearsal and live broadcast of the Eamon Andrews Show, aired between 11:05 and 11:50 p.m. The Fabs appeared on the show 3 times, first in an opening 10-minute interview chat segment with Eamon Andrews himself, in which they discussed the making of their new film, their success, and the likelihood of going solo in case of a split-up. Then, they appeared miming a performance of Ticket to Ride and Yes It Is. Finally, they joined Andrews, newspaper columnist Catherine Whitehorn and author-critic Wolf Mankowitz for a lengthy discussion forum that you can hear via the link in the episode description. It's audio only and the quality is not too great, but it's better than nothing, I guess. And since we added it, in the episode description you will also find a link to my support page. Please be fab and show me that you care. You can make the difference in helping me to focus even more on producing free music-related content with an ever-increasing production value. Thank you! On the 11th of April 1966, the Beatles reconvened at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road, London. The 2:30 to 7 p.m. session, after the guitar overdub on Got to Get You Into My Life, quickly moved on the recording of the basic track of George Harrison's Love You Too, the first Indian-flavoured song of the band. The piece, still called Granny Smith, initially only featured George on acoustic guitar and vocals, and Paul McCartney on backing vocals. By take 3 though, tabla player Anil Bhagwat and an unknown member of the Asian music circle in North London at the sitar and tambura were added to the ensemble. The basic track was completed after a dinner break, before the end of the second booked session, by 12:45 a.m. A rough mono mix of the song was then made between 12:45 and 1 a.m. for George to take home. In 1967, returning at John and Michelle Phillips' house in Los Angeles, Paul McCartney arranged a jam session with the two members of the Mamas and the Papas and Beach Boys Brian Wilson. Paul played glasses filled with water, a cello, and a flugel horn. After the early morning jam, Paul and Beatles assistant Moll Evans returned to Derek Taylor's house for a quick breakfast before getting ready to leave the States. After working as the Beatles' press officer, Taylor had relocated to California and offered his services to local bands like the Birds, the Beach Boys, and the Mamas and the Papas. In 1969, Get Back was issued in UK as a single, with Don't Let Me Down on the B-side. It was the Beatles' 19th single and the first song to be released from the Get Back sessions of January 1969. Many shops didn't receive a copy of the single, though, due to Paul McCartney asking for a remix of the song on the 7th of April, as detailed in episode 97 of What a Fab Day. Get Back was the last Beatles single to be released in mono, and the first time another musician was named on the cover. The song and Don't Let Me Down were credited to the Beatles with Billy Preston. This leads us to the conclusion of another episode of What a Fab Day. Tune in tomorrow to find out more about Paul's idea for Magical Mystery Tour. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation. Simon Mas, music you love.